Okay, so players have a board in front of them containing decks of these cards, which allow different actions to be taken each turn. Briefly, survey gets you new planets to acquire. You can acquire these planets either by force via warfare cards or with the power of villages through colonize. Research gets you new tech cards and allows you to streamline your deck, and produce/trade lets you wield the power of industry. Politics is just a freebie card. Starting with one planet in front of them, each player will use their 5 cards in hand to take an optional action and a mandatory role, but more on that when we play. Once this is done, you just discard any unwanted cards that you don't want and draw back up to 5. Because it's a deck building game, whenever your draw pile is empty, simply shuffle your discards and you're good to go. From these cards, players will just get more and more planets into their empire, allowing access to buy better technologies, which makes doing what you want to do that much easier. These planets have requirements to conquer either through peace or war as described before, and when done so are flipped over to indicate the planet is now under that person's control. The person that gets the most influence points through planets, trading, and tech wins. Let's get started.
Okie doke, Eminent Domain. Let's get started. We've done all our usual setup stuff, all our components are sorted, we've got our different piles of cards for each of our, we've got different types of technologies based on our planets. We have our metallic, our earth fertile ones, and we have our Mars-like ones.
Mars-like one is metallic.
Is that the metallic one? And that's the advanced, metallic, advanced, and
fertile.
There we go. And we have our alien or planets over here with the types on top with their requirements. All our different cards here we have given, because we're doing two players, we've given each other two of these things here. One of them has the start player on the back, so we'll reveal who that is now.
Yes!
So that's you. So we can get rid of these off to the side now. That gives us a bit more space. We each have a starting planet, rather than turning it over, because we're not supposed to do that within the first thing. I'll just describe what we each have. We're pretty much identical. In fact, we are identical, with the exception of the type of planet. I've got a 2 warfare, 2 colonize metallic planet, and Kris has a 2 warfare, 2 colonize fertile planet. So that might end up swaying things a wee bit, depending on what we go for. We've shuffled our decks already. You're the starting player, so let me draw 5. And we're good to go. And again, hopefully you should be able to see everything.
Roll and boost it with 1.
Okay.
For 2. And that's. Discard those 2. Draw the next 2. Back up to 5.
Cool. What did you do? Oh, you colonized roll, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
I shall follow. Technically, you're supposed to do this. I was caught off guard there. You're supposed to follow. Before the whole cleanup phase, but that was me slipping, so I shall follow the colonize.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, when or in the rules, essentially your cleanup happens for the person whose turn it was, so I don't have to draw back up to 5 here or anything like that. So I essentially stay at my limit until it comes back around to me, and then I still have to do my action roll, and then I can do my cleanup to draw more cards in as I see fit. Well, 2 of these are useless right now, so I may as well get my politics out of the road, which allows me to, once I remove that from the game, I take any one roll card from the stacks and put it into my hand. So that's off to the side now, and I shall obviously take the colonize roll, put that into my hand, play said colonize roll, and ordinarily it would just be 1+1 colony per colonize symbol, but as the leader I may settle a planet instead. So I flip this over, and these now all go into my discard pile. The way I tend to play it, just to keep everything Nice and tidy. I tend to have my discard pile upside down facing me, so I always know, in case I get confused with all the different piles and stuff like that, I usually keep my draw to the right hand side, discard to the left, or discard in front of me upside down. That's just the way I roll.
Descent,
which allows you to draw a card, and it's now time for my cleanup phase. I shall discard that and draw back up to 5. 4 and 5. And that's me.
Use my politics.
Mm-hmm.
Research.
Okay.
Doesn't discard that.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, sorry.
Gets removed from the game.
Like that. Colonize for my roll.
Uh-huh.
Get my planet on the go. Discard those. And I will discard that.
You keep jumping the gun with my descenting.
You're just not quick enough.
Yes, clearly. So I shall descent and get that into my hand. And you've already burnt through all your things. You're now shuffling your deck again.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So back to me. I shall produce slash trade as my action, which allows me to produce one resource, and I have a nice little bit of ore here, so that goes on there, that goes into my discard, and for my roll I shall take a survey. I also have 2 in my hand, so I'm going to boost that to 3 total. Survey roll allows me to look at the number of symbols minus 1 planet cards and keep 1. So essentially I get to look at the top 3 minus 1, which is 2.
No, you're the leader.
And I look at, yep, I look at an additional card, thanks for helping me. So I get to look at 3. And, oh dear. Essentially I get to look at both sides of these. Ordinarily you're not supposed to, but, or you just have access to like what your spaceship, I suppose, would be able to see. Whereas with this one, you get to survey in a bit more detail. And I only get to keep 1 of these. So I'll keep that one. And these 2 get discarded to the bottom. And that can go next to that one there. Would you care to descent or follow?
I'll descent.
Descent. And I now get to clean up. I shall keep all 3. I'm out of my draw, so I get to shuffle again. Oi. Draw a pile back. I need another 2 cards. And with that, that is my turn finished.
I'll skip my action.
Okay.
I'll survey roll for 2.
2 cards.
And this one shall go away.
And shall descent. And I must go away as well.
Oops,
I shall trade for my action. I'll just quickly get rid of this one here for a victory point. And that goes into my discard. And for my roll, I shall take a research. And I shall boost it with another 2. So that allows me access to a 3 cost. I still only have, even though I do have an advanced planet within my deck, I haven't colonized it or warfared it to death. to get into my possession yet, so I have to basically be confined to what I have here, which limits me to the metallic planets. That one. That all goes back there. My research goes there, and does that go into my hand or does that go into the discard?
Listen to your hand. If it's a technology, it goes into your hand.
So that goes into my hand, so I've now got that to work with. That was my roll, guess you dissented. It's time for my cleanup. Plenty of cards, I think we shall. Okay.
Produce some wheat or whatever the hell it is.
Uh-huh.
And we'll survey rubble.
Uh-huh.
So look at the top two.
I think I want to follow.
And we need at least two to follow.
At least two to follow. I do have the cards. And I'm thinking that would be better enough. Yeah, we'll keep that stuff. We'll follow with our survey and our come on, improved research, which has their survey symbol at the top, mm-hmm. 2-1, since I'm not the leader, I only get to look at this card and keep it, so that's fine. Those all go there, those go into discard, and back to me. Produce action again. Okay, that one there. And that's warfare roll. We'll boost it with that, which allows me to collect one fighter per thing that I have, and I've only got those two there. So we'll take these bad boys, stack them there for the moment. You choose to descent, and now it's time for my cleanup. I have four there, so I may as well just take all those. And that's my turn.
Trade this in.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll colonize roll.
Okay.
Let's start with 3. Let's be 4 on that.
Okay. Do you mind if you do that just so that I know that you're going for that one? I shall follow. I have 3 in my hand, so I shall stack these 3 under here like so. And I followed, so it's your cleanup phase now. Discard 1, dear.
Going to sleeve.
Draw up to 5. Cool. Me to go. I shall skip the action phase. So since there's no reason to, and I shall take a survey roll, which I shall follow with another two, which gives me access to the top three planets. I shall keep that one. So those go into my discard pile. Oops. You're dissenting, so now these get shuffled. Cool. Nothing to discard, so I'll just draw up to five again. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's my turn.
Action, I'll settle this planet.
Okay.
Research. This is 3. This one is 5.
Nice.
I suppose I probably won't be able to get any because I've only got one planet. I just want to do the cards.
Yes, your 3's cost one planet, your 5's cost 2, and your 7's cost 3.
So I get rid of the cards.
I would like to follow, but I don't have enough cards, so I'm just going to descent.
And I'll take that one. Keep them.
Right. I need to go. Let's skip the action phase again, and actually, yeah, tell you what, let's instead do a warfare roll, and we shall boost it 3 times.
Twice?
Sorry. Okay. 3 times total is what I meant to say, and that allows me to collect one fighter per symbol, so I'll get another 3 into my arsenal. Let's go now into that. That still has only 3 colonize on it. So that was my roll. So now clean up. I shall just take one from here. That's me.
Dissented. Bits of resource.
Okay.
And I'll survey roll.
Okay.
Just step by 3.
I shall follow. I shall just follow with 3.
I think it should be the top 2.
Top 2 there. Tap.
And we'll get the leader bones.
Let's go there. That's my hand. I get to look at these. And. Space now. Yeah, this was the 4, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so I choose to follow. You have 3. Mm-hmm. There you go. In that case, I will. What do I want to do? Yeah, it should be coming up shortly. So instead, let's skip our action. Do warfare roll again, but I've got nothing to collect. I will attack a planet instead. I've got 5 fighters, so I can go pretty much anywhere I want. What do I want? I want to get this one. Oops. 1, 2, 3, 4. So essentially, useful symbol in the top middle there, indicating that I can now have another card. So, in my hand at any given time, so my hand limit has been increased to 6. That now goes into the discard pile, my cleanup, keep those there. We'll go 1, you're choosing the descent, 2, 3. Survey roll. Okay. Just the 3. Get 4. Oh. I'm only at 5. Sorry.
Yeah. Draw back up.
That's it. A survey, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So I'm 6, so I choose to descent. Survey action, which allows me to draw 2 cards, and then shuffle these. Okay, so that goes there. Survey action goes into discard pile. Draw 2 cards. That's 1. 2, and we will do a research roll, which we will boost with 1, 2, 3, 4, giving me a total of 5 signs. Unfortunately, the only planet that I have is the metallic type, so my 5 power has to come from there. I can go there, I can go there. Okay. on. There, that all goes there, so now that all goes into the discard pile, this goes into my hand, finish my roll, so now I clean it up, I shall...
Are you going to fall?
Yeah,
I'll follow.
Okay. That's three. Clean up, I will. I'm just going to do this card there. That's yours. So that's four, so I get to have five and six because of my hand limit. And that's my turn. I shall descent.
Mm-hmm.
You done?
Okay.
Go. Do another survey action to draw two cards. It's the last two in the deck. Ones in my hand, so that allows me to collect five fighters. Oops. One, two, three, four, and five, so that's six total. Now it's time for their cleanup. You've descended, so I'll get rid of just that one. Shuffle these. Three in my hand, so I'll draw another three. One, two, three. Good. Yep.
No survey action.
Okay.
Draw two cards. I'll colonize a roll. Just step by two.
Back in, or do you want me to reshuffle the whole?
Yeah, well, you wouldn't be able to do that anyway.
Well, those were the went back into that pile there, the discards. So I'll just shuffle it back into this one.
Just shuffle it back into the discard.
Ah, that's the thing, there's no discard now. Like, these are my draw pile. That was my discard pile, but it's now, if you get what I'm saying.
Shuffle it in the draw pile.
Just checking. Because like I've essentially went and drawn those cards now. Like there was a chance that the warfare ones could have came in there, but he's a right good shuffle. Right. Sorry about that. So, that you done?
Yep.
Need to go. The survey action. Get two cards. And we will acquire another one. Warfare roll. Boost it with that. Although, to be honest, I'm not collecting stuff, so I don't know why I'm boosting it. Take that back. I'll attack a planet instead. And I think it was this one. Yep. Four fighters, one. 2, 3, 4. And that now allows me another card increase to my hand limit. So I can now have 7 in my hand at any point in time. You're dissenting. That goes into my discard. Clean up. I will 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm actually at my limit, so I don't have to. But I'll get rid of that just to get rid of it. Get that. That's me.
I will improve to colonize action, which allows me to settle 2 planets instead of just 1. I'll settle both of these.
Nice attempt.
Discard.
To produce 1 resource per production symbol, so I shall produce 2 things. Get an ore there and some wheat there. That's me. It's a small picky thing, but the blue ones are for the end game.
Okay.
Okie doke. So, turn to go now. I shall use my mobilization action, which allows me to collect 2 fighters, and I may attack 1 planet after your roll phase this turn. So as soon as my roll phase is turned, I'll be attacking that planet there. And for my roll, I'll just colonize. Sadly, that's still at 3, which is now up to 4, so I can be good to go. Play mine. So that's 4 under that one. And I... Oops. That goes away. Finish my roll phase, and I'll trade in these 4 here. And get my planet here. And then my cleanup. So I've got 4 in my hand, so I can have 7 total. So that's another 3 cards. 1, 2, and 3. And that's me. This reaction. Survey roll. Okay. I shall follow with 3 as well, so that allows me access to the next 2. 1 and 2. So that's there. Both followed. Right, me go. Warfare action, just collect a fighter, nothing to attack, and I will, I'll just get this out the road. I'll just colonize this planet here, got nothing to boost it with. But all those go into there. This becomes colonized, which gives him another plus 1, so I can now have 8 hand or 8 cards in my hand. And with that roll, I shall draw back up with 3 in my hand, so I get 5 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Might as well shuffle my discard. Oof, dear. Discard while I'm here. Go. So that's there.
Research.
Okay.
Draw a card and remove up to 3 cards in hand from the game.
Okay.
Remove that.
Yep. You don't have to let me see.
Up to 3. So I'll just remove that one.
Okay.
Pick up the others. And I'll colonize them all. This that. Those two, drop back up to 5.
I think I shall follow likewise. Improved research. Draw a card. Remove up to three in game. So that's discarded. Draw one. I don't want to get rid of that, unfortunately. So that's my action. And for my roll, I will simply research and boost that. That's me. 5 research. Goes into my discard, although I still only have metallics to choose from, so. Anything. Nope. So I'll just draw 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Roll action, improved colonize. This has 2. Plus the long colonize from here makes 3. Instead of settling on another planet, I can use plus one colony.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll put that in there.
Okay, so that's you at 3 out of 5.
Mm-hmm.
I
have not done my roll yet.
Sorry. I shall descent. Not yet.
Mm-hmm.
Survey action. 2. Trade for my roll and boost it with nothing else in my hand. Nope. So that's just 2 production. So I will get an ore and some ash coal type thing. Oops. I'm not supposed to be turning up. Yep. There we go. So that goes there. And stays there. What will I get rid of? Let's keep those. Hope that comes up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Discard that. That's me.
Colonize action. It's four there, plus the one makes five.
Set. There you go.
Yeah.
What will I do? I will survey team for my action, which allows me to take the top card of the planet deck and put it into my empire face down. Total of five fighters. One, two, three, four, five. So that's a total of six. And those all go into my discard. And get rid of stuff, get rid of stuff. That, draw four. One, two, three, four. That's me.
Oh, I forgot that's a plus one. I only dropped five. I've got six because I descended.
Yeah, go for it. Looks it easy.
Right. Skip the action phase.
Okay.
Colonize roll is three.
Descent.
Drop back up to six now.
Me to go. I will mobilization action, which allows me to collect two fighters, and I can attack a planet after the roll phase. So that's one and two. And for my roll. And we'll boost with just the one card, so that allows me to trade two items away for two victory points. But I will do this instead. Okay. So that's me sitting at 4, 6, 7. That was the end of my roll phase. I get to attack a planet due to my mobilization action, and I'll do this one here, which costs 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And final cleanup. I've got 4, 7 in my hand, and I can have a total of 8. Usually quite a quick game, but okay, and for my cleanup, I will get rid of those two, draw these two, and that's me.
Call that action, that point is 3 plus the one there. 4. So that's that one there, which gives me another increase in my hand size. Discard that. And cyber roll, boosted by 3, which gives me 4 planet. Okay.
I shall follow with 2. Actually, no, that only lets me look at 1, doesn't it? Let's not do that.
Well, but I've seen it now.
I don't need any more metallic planets in that thing. Survey action. Draw 2 cards, hopefully they're what I want. That'll do. My action for my roll. Research, boost it with that, which allows me access to one of anything. Enough. soon as they've been discarded, that goes into my hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'll get rid of that one. Draw up. Good stuff.
That's me.
Survey action. Draw two. We'll research world. And shall decide. This, that, one.
Five, six.
Yep. 6, 7.
Cool.
To the 7 from the advanced or the fertile. Or the 5s if I wanted. Go with dissension.
Okay. Which allows you to draw one additional card when dissenting. Let's see, permanent technology, as denoted in the top left, so that essentially just stays up front, doesn't go into your hand. Search roll, I dissented. You drawn back up? My action will be improved research, draw a card, remove up to 3 in hand from game. And my roll let's just produce slash trade again, which allows me to get rid of 2 of my things for 2 victory points. And clean up. Get rid of those. Get rid of that. So that's 8. So I can have another 6 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I shall follow. I might keep that card though. I definitely have to follow that one. Definitely keep that. There's nothing that I really want to get for that turn, that's the thing. Follow.
roll with that. So that allows two survey symbols.
You still got it forward.
I was going to say the advanced one that was on top.
But
there was an advanced one that was on top now.
Did I put those back on top?
Yeah.
I did.
I was going to say.
So you need to set the ones I want.
There we go. Cool. So I shall keep this one. Get rid of the. Oops. Those two. That's me followed. You're clean up. You're first.
Yeah, my clean up's done.
Cool. What am I going to do? Do a mobilization action. Which again, collect two fighters and attack a planet at the end of the roll phase. We will do. /trade for the roll. I'll follow that up with another two, so that's three total, and it will be producing.
See, when you're colonizing, you can only go on one planet at a time.
What do you mean?
Like, say you've got a whole ton of colonizers, could you split it between two?
Clarify it either.
Check.
That's what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure we've looked through them before. They don't have an FAQ or anything like that. I can't be bothered looking at it, to be honest. I'm assuming you've got enough to do both. Or near enough.
Pretty much. It's fine, never mind.
Right. Where were we? I just done a produce slash trade that you dissented, so it's my cleanup. I've got three in my hand, so I'll draw another five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Right, so that's me drawing my five. And my. I'm just getting these cards in order first. I get to attack a planet. I really would like to do the advance, but I have to settle for the fertile. Cost me 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's me. Okay.
Survey action. Draw 2.
Come.
Colonize a roll. Are you going to follow a descent?
Colonize, I shall descent. Discard that one. This. Research action. Get rid of two cards. Game. And for my roll, I will do survey. That's two. Four, nothing more. One, two, three, four. Perfect. Sorry, my turn or
no?
Or my cleanup, right? Right. So that's that stuff done there. So now just need to tighten that up and get back to doing our cleanup. Get rid of that one. Put 3 plus 3. And shuffle. And it's going to survey action.
Okay.
Draw two. Colonize roll. One, no, this, that. Two, because that's all I need. Shall descent. Ooh, I have to discard one, so get rid of that. Right. Here you go. Let's we shall ignore an action. We'll do a survey roll. Now the game ends when one stack is completely depleted. We have
mm-hmm.
4 survey left. If we were playing a longer version of the game, you could maybe go for 2. It's kind of flexible when it comes to that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll go for the shorter version of the game. And if you're playing like a 3-player short, it's 2 stacks, and then a 3-player or a 4-player is, I think, 3 stacks or something like that. Our colonize has 3 left, and those have got plenty.
Mm-hmm.
So we shall do a survey roll. Boost it with those 2. Gets me 3 cards. 1, 2, and 3. There. Don't want that. Take that one. Go to the bottom. That's me. Run out of space. So my discard pile is now over on the left here. So now my cleanup. I will not discard anything. So that's 7 and 1 is 8.
I'll colonize action on this planet.
Mm-hmm.
We have 3, but 4th from that planet. That gives me enough.
Okay.
I will produce trade roll. We start with 3. And I will create 4 resources.
Go. Shall descent. And do a warfare roll to collect one fighter per thing. I've got one, that's two, three, four, five, six, seven. So that's seven fighters. Three, four, five, six. Seven. Good stuff. And I shall discard that as well. So I'm using the four, draw up to eight. One, two, three, four. Shall descent.
This one, if we need to fight right out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And I will not discard any of these. I'll drop back at 7.
2 cards. Let's reset roll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it, 5. There, so I now have still, I've got 2 fertile, except I don't think any of these are the ones that I want. Nope. So I'll go to here instead.
Three, four, five.
Yep. lineup will be those four. I guess it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Turn it.
Mm-hmm.
Savvy action. Draw two. Colonize all. Step with two. Don't need to, but I'll get rid of them. I'll show you this out. Mobilization action, collect two fighters. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. And my roll shall be slash trade, left that, and nothing else. I shall trade two resources to get two victory points. And my cleanup shall be those. Five, so that's three cards. 1, 2, 3. That's me.
Colonize action. Sell this planet.
Okay.
Search roll, list it to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay.
I'll take productivity.
Okay. Which essentially you may play
an additional card for its action effect during your action phase.
Nice. That was research. I'm going to choose to descent, I think. Shuffle my deck. That's good to go for next time. Is that you?
Yeah, that's me.
Cool. I will do Warpath action, which allows me to tack up to two planets.
Mm-hmm.
And I shall choose both advanced. This one costs 4. And this one costs me 5, which means I can cash in all nine of my things. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, like nice. Oh, those were supposed to be in there. God damn it. Easy to lose track. Right, and that's my action. And now for my roll. What is that? Is that plus nothing else? I will do a research roll. Three, which allows me to get three of anything. I don't think there's anything here though. That one. So that's research. Research roll. Clean up. I will keep those. Get rid of that one. That's five in my hand, which means three. 1, 2, 3. That's me.
I get to play two action effects because of productivity, so I'll play two survey cards.
Mm-hmm.
So I draw four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Resources. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Get myself 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So that leaves 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That leaves 8 in the pile. I think I will follow. And I have my improved trade for 1, 2, 3, 4. Gets me 4 resources. And then to your cleanup.
Mm-hmm. Fine.
There you go. Mate, go. I will then. I do improved research action. Draw 1, remove up to 3. Get rid of that one. Get rid of that one. That, and I shall do warfare roll. 1, 2. Keep that. But that's 2, 3, 4. Uh, Ah, yeah, that's fine. Two, four, so that's four fighters. Oh, dear. One, two, three. Four. Four fighters. And that goes into discard, you're dissenting, my cleanup, I'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that's fine. Right, here you go.
Draw my second dissent card. This here.
Right, so I've dissented your cleanup. Action to collect two fighters and attack at the end of the turn. And I will produce slash trade roll and do three there, four, five to trade five resources. Points.
With one.
One, two, three, four, five. One. So now we have three victory points in the top. So essentially, when that goes, we each get an equal number of turns to do any last trading or stuff that we want to do, and then that's what the blue ones are for. To essentially allow stuff over and above the end of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So we're getting close, but not quite there yet. So that was a produce. So my cleanup now. We will get rid of those two. And that was me four. One, two, three, four. That's my turn.
Okay.
You're not helping him out here, are you?
I'm not supposed to.
One, two, three, four, five.
The way I see it, I play it like Munchkin. If you don't catch on to it, it's your own fault.
True. So that's a plus one hand limit again, but that happened... Oh, actually, that happened after the roll, so I can actually hold another card in my hand. Good stuff.
I will double action the productivity.
Mm-hmm.
Do a double colonize. Plus, that one gets me three, so I will colonize roll.
Mm-hmm.
Settle that place. Mm-hmm.
what was that? Colonizer. Descent. May as well survey action. Draw two cards, I've only got one.
See, could I take that last colonize, even though I don't have anything to use it on? Because I can't settle a planet and I can't attach it to anything. Because I've just. I would imagine you'd just add that to your deck.
You can just take it, and then you just. Well. Yeah.
Add it to the deck.
And then you just add it to your hand. Yeah. So is that you saying I've got like two turns left?
Maybe.
Well, these are good cards then.
Do you keep tracking resources for these?
Alright, so that was one card, second card. Alright. So that was survey action. So let's do. I'll do warfare roll. So that goes there, 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 and there. So that's 5, 6, 7 fighters. Two,
descent,
3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, 7. And that all goes to the discard. And I shall get rid of these two. Five, so I can now hold extra 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's me.
First action, trade that in for a point. Second action, improved research. Draw a card and move up to 3, but I won't remove any.
Okay.
I will research roll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay.
Ooh. What? Why are you shaking your head?
You son of a bitch.
It's only 7 left. I've got the other 2. And I will take adaptability. Your standard research roll cards gain all symbols that can be used to boost or follow any roll.
What a waste. Right, well that'll be that then.
Why?
Another one's so much better, but...
And you remove any number of cards in hand from the game each
just
turn.
Just get rid of your shite. That's the whole point of it. But, whatever.
Nah, I prefer adaptability.
Fuck. Right, well, I'll follow then. Try and make up for what I can. Right, in that case I shall go and follow with weapon. What are these? Probably not gonna see the light of day anyway. So I will follow, and that was 5 research for that. That will go back into my hand. Weapon Emporium essentially allows me to trade fighters as if they were resources.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my follow, so your cleanup.
No, I'm fine.
There you go. Alright.
Actually. Any use to me.
Research action.
Okay.
Get rid of two cards, I'll get rid of those ones. And produce slash trade roll. Boosted with that. We shall it's thinking because if I trade I'm only gonna get I would get another fighter as well. Yeah, let's trade.
We'll trade.
Show your card.
Sorry.
Trade roll.
Okay.
So I'll get rid of that. Well, actually, no. There's two there. Three, four. So I get rid of four things. That's one, two, three, four. So I have these two here, plus an extra bonus two. For that, which essentially we've burnt through all the black victory point ones, which essentially means that's the end of the game, but each person gets an equal number of turns.
So I'll get one more turn.
You'll get one more turn and that'll be us. And I have...
Was that your roll?
That was my roll, so clean up or just draw back up to eight. No, nine, sorry. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hopefully there's something decent in here.
Even if I can get... Even if I get a new planet, I can't colonize it in the same turn.
Nope. You have shit all to trade.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say
I will survey to draw two cards for my first action. Produce for my second. It's one production there. Two. So I produce two resources. And I will trade roll. One, two, my deck of ally. I do have a third trade up there, but I only have two resources.
Two resources, I shall follow.
That's the best I can do. Yeah, I've cleaned up done.
Cool. I shall follow with the rest of my things, which gets me 4, 6, but only got 5 fighters. So those 5. Go in.
There's only 4 points left.
Inefficiency. And I get those. And with that.
Well, you've still got one more turn, don't you? Does your turn count as the initiation?
Well, you were the starting player, so it has to go back to you. It should finish on you for the equal number of turns, shouldn't it?
Okay.
Unless I'm thinking about that wrong, because I mean, you go, then I go, then you go. So,
I just thought you'd have another turn. Yeah, because it goes back to me. You're technically the second player. I go first, then you go second.
Right. But if I finish the game.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah, because you finished. You initiated it.
The end
game. Yeah, okay.
It would go back to you. I would have gotten another turn if you had finished it.
Oh,
yeah.
Right, okay.
Well, yeah, we'll say it's that way.
Unless I lose, of course, in which case, yeah, we're going back to this.
No, you're not.
And with that, we shall take a momentary pause here. We'll total all of this mess up, see what we end up with, and we'll come back to you with the results.
Right.
Okay, so as you might be able to see, technology wins the day, as is most often the case. I come in with a fairly respectable 52, but it is sadly no mean match for you. You come in with pretty decent.
Yeah, pretty decent 68.
Yep. So, yeah, that was annoying. I'm trying to wonder what I could have done better there.
No, because you've never beaten me at Eminent Domain.
Yeah.
But you've always gotten close every time.
Yeah.
The first time there was like a 30 point difference. Then it was like 12 points. And the last game we played, you got 49 and I got 50.
Mm. And it's went back the other way this time.
You're always obsessed with warfare. Every time you play the game, you're obsessed.
Because you're always obsessed with colonize. So it's like, why battle you with like colonize? I can just go for warfare and get all those cards.
Works both ways though. You don't battle me for colonize.
Mm-hmm. True. Cool. So with that, we'll wrap this game up here.
You'll defeat me one day.
I will. So annoyed.
And it will be the day where I let you win.
Yes, exactly.
No, you did play really well.
Oh, that hurts even more.
No, I do genuinely mean that. There was a lot of times where I wanted to, like...
Yeah.
You picked roll cards, which both helped you more to the detriment of me. That's why I picked up that Dissidence, or whatever the hell it's called, card.
Yeah.
Because I was dissension. Dissension. I was dissenting all the time, so I thought, I'll pick that up.
Yeah. Yeah, anyway. You'll probably pick it up on the thing when I say...
When he screams it to me.
Yes. Son of a bitch. When he picks up the 7 technology card that I was working towards the entire time for hyper-efficiency to streamline my deck. That was the ultimate goal that I was aiming towards, and he just snatched it out.
Well, we had a big discussion about this right after we finished the game. I don't really streamline my deck. Yeah, whereas that's the whole point.
Actually,
according to you, that seems to be the whole point of the game, but I don't really
It's the whole point of the genre. It's what I feel like deck building as a thing. You start off with crappy cards, and then you use those crappy cards to take actions and roles, in this case, Eminent Domains being a specific example, and that allows you to streamline your deck, and then because you're getting rid of the crap cards, you're left with awesome cards, and you're taking awesome cards on a much higher frequency, therefore you're able to do much more. But you seem to be defying the system when it comes to...
That's because I am a wizard.
Yes. Unless I'm just like really terrible at this game, like... It's because it hurts you. Well, hurts is a bit strong.
Hurts the pain.
The pain. It annoys me because I really enjoy it. At least this is probably one of my top games that I have in my collection. Like, I will almost never turn a game of it down. But
you've never won one.
I've never.
Sorry.
Yeah, I've never won it once.
Well, we've only played it how many times? Five? Four?
Yeah, a handful of times. Like, maybe half a dozen.
Five or less.
Yeah. So, I don't know. Maybe I just need to take a page out of your book and just, like, stop trying to beat the system and just go with what I'm given. But it feels annoying because that, to me, is, like, the entire point of the system.
I think it's a little bit more forgiving than other deck-building games and other streamlining games. Because the whole roll-action thing and the bonuses and all those technology cards, like...
What do you mean? For other games?
I think it's a bit more... It's obviously quicker paced than other deck-building games. I think so, because, I mean, like, in the sense that, like, if you're playing Magic the Gathering, I mean, you're locked away in a dungeon for 4 hours the night before, like, coming up with your deck and, like, picking the cards you want to play and all that stuff. Like, I mean, I think it's much more simplified than other deck-building games. Mm. And I think that simplicity... affords you some freedom in the streamlining.
Yeah.
And that, like, you don't absolutely have to
streamline or you lose.
Yeah.
But you can make the deck work in your favour, which is what I usually do.
I mean, I think we've not really shown the quickness of Eminent Domain, because it says like 45 minutes or
yeah,
so, 10 hours.
The camera kept dying.
Yeah.
Then people started setting off fireworks and we had to stop filming.
It was just too, like, really long for some reason. But yeah, it's I feel, because I'm in two minds about it, because I feel that everything that has been said is that this should be a fairly quick game. Now, granted, I am guilty of taking too long to make decisions when it comes to this thing, because I like to consider all my options, you know, before doing anything. But, and that kind of, you know, that kind of protracts the game out, unfortunately. But, it should be a quick game, like, all things considered, because it, mechanically, it's super simple. It's, to me, and more, well, to fit, you know, to, like, mechanically very simple, but to me, it has just that little bit more meat that I think Dominion, personally, I think is missing. Like, granted, there's, like, umpteen expansions at this point that increase the complexity of base, you know, vanilla Dominion, like, in terms of, like, your actions and, you know, your cards that you get within it. But for me, there just needs to be something a bit more. I don't really find the draw of deck building just for the sake of deck building to be particularly appealing, and that's where, to me, Eminent Domain, I feel, is a hell of a lot better, because there's other stuff that you can do as well, like your deck building, but it's always in service of either, you know, you're trading stuff, or you're colonizing planets, or, you know, you're warfaring planets to death, or whatever it is, and you're getting new research and technologies, albeit it's a very simple research track, you know, it's just like number of symbols, cash it in, you know, there's nothing super complicated about it, but to me, just that little bit more stuff that you're doing, even though, again, it's all very simple, that little bit more takes it to where I will always go for Eminent Domain over Dominion. But again, that's just me personally. I know tons
in
of people
a weird way,
love
it's like
Dominion.
It's simpler, but there's still more to consider. It's like a weird sort of paradox. Like, the rules are very simple, the functions of the cards are very simple, but there's lots of ways that your actions can stem off.
True. I mean, there are, I won't say there's handfuls of ways to win, because you can either win by essentially going down a very research-heavy track, you know, and essentially just gobbling up all the research things and getting points that way, or you can go for a very colonizing planets, warfaring planets strategy, you know, where you're constantly getting survey cards to get new planets and then just warfare and colonize and just, you know, doing what you did essentially, and just keeping that cycle going to just get more and more planets into your empire. Or you can go, like, kind of the only way, other way I think you can win is really with, like, trading and stuff like that, where you keep, you build up your empire to a reasonable level, I would say maybe like 5 planets or so, and then you just do produce slash trade, and you essentially just try and gobble through all the victory points before the other guys have a chance to really, that's a bit more
in the early end game.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's a bit more risky, because, well, I say risky, like, you're essentially, you have to be very dedicated to that one, I would say, you know, because
and kind of locks you in. But
I mean, the strategy is the lock in as well, I suppose. But I would say that might be the one slight detriment, is that you kind of have to pick a strategy very early on, you know, see what the other guy's doing and kind of do the opposite, at least in a two-player game, is, like, it was the case for me. I mean, granted, we were both, like, trying to get as many planets into our empire as possible. But that could be a potential downside to it, is that there are only really a handful of ways to win, you know, and if you keep playing it over and over again, you're going to quickly realise what you're doing and stuff like that. Which is why, segue, I'm really looking forward to Escalation, the first sequel to Eminent Domain, because if I have read my things correctly, it's essentially going to be adding in a bit of a warfare element, like player interaction, or more so player interaction type thing, where you can essentially attack other people's colonies and planets and stuff like that.
you know, a la, well, any other space game, I suppose, that has that kind of stuff. Mm. I'm trying to think one off the top of my head.
Oh, there's that big one with the big, like, negotiate. You know, there was like all these character cards, and there's like the green, the yellow, and the red hard ones. I played the pacifist, and he wins on negotiate cards.
Oh, Cosmic Encounter.
Cosmic Encounter. I didn't even know what the hell it was called.
That's not really.
That's space shooting down ships.
Yeah, I suppose you've got.
That's as close as you're going to get.
Yeah, I was thinking somewhere more along the lines of like Eclipse or something like that, or
don't know about
that. Race for the Galaxy type things, although the warfare in Race for the Galaxy is a wee bit. But anyway, that's a side tangent. Looking forward to the sequel. Hopefully it allows me better ways to kick your arse.
Attempt
to kick your arse. Nine
Try
ways
to overthrow the Emperor.
Yeah. Again, don't know much of the details on it, but the Kickstarters, last time I read, were supposed to be shipping out in December. I was made aware of it, sadly, too late to get in on it. Although, to be honest, I rarely, again, this is a side topic for another day, but I rarely back Kickstarters for like games and stuff like that, because first production runs are always kind of susceptible to problems in some cases, you know. Sometimes they knock it out of the park first try, such as Eminent Domain. We got it right first time, no problems at all. Well, no major problems at least, anyway. But I usually tend to avoid doing like first run things just in case there are problems. But that will mean I will have to pick it up sometime when it comes out in early 2014, probably. Would be my best guess of when it's coming out.
Might get out for Christmas, you know.
They might get out. But I mean, typically what they tend to do is they tend to satisfy the Kickstarter backers first. And they tend to do like a first production run, and like they all go out to the Kickstarters, and then they'll start gearing up for a second run, and then that comes out like a month or so later. But anyway, enough. What's the word?
Rambling.
We shall leave it at this. I really, 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 really like Eminent Domain. Dare I say, love Eminent Domain.
I really like it, which is weird because like it's not the kind of game I'd go for.
Mm.
It's like. It's not very fantasy. It's sci-fi. I mean, like, sci-fi is not usually my kind of genre.
Mm-hmm.
I find sci-fi a bit overwhelming.
Mm.
I prefer fantasy. But I do. It's a fun game.
Yeah.
I mean, it's fun, simple-ish.
Yep.
Can be as simple as you want it to be. But no, I do like it. I just don't. I'm not as enthusiastic about it as you are.
Yeah, I think, to me, I really enjoy it because I always feel like, it's hard to explain, like, I always feel like I can be doing better at it, you know, I can always be improving how I go about stuff, and then I inevitably end up losing anyway. But I think it's just because you have, like, so many options available, and while there are, like, a few set strategies, you're never, at least to me, you're never really locked in at all. Because, again, you can always just burn away the cards. Granted, it'll take quite a few turns, but you can always just burn away the cards that you're not wanting at any point in time. You can be flexible, or you can be quite rigid in your strategy, and, you know, the mechanics allow for such thing. Looking forward to playing with more than two players. Again, we've played it umpteen times, or about five. It's pretty much the same. But I would really like to see how the dynamic changes with three or four, because again, you'll have multiple people following and the decks will be burning through quicker, and you'll have more people that, while
definitely end a lot quicker.
That should do. I mean, I was just going to say there with like, because you could have one person that doesn't do the follow role that you want, but then the next person might do the one that you want to do when it comes around, you know, and stuff like that. But yeah, we'll definitely. I mean, I don't know if our parents might get into it. Maybe a wee bit tricky for them. Hopefully we'll be able to find a couple of people to play it with at some point in time. But we shall see. So yeah, I would say very enthusiastic thumbs up.
Enthusiastic
thumbs up. It's certainly one of my top games in my collection, without a doubt.
And anything else to finish up on? Nothing else? Cool. So with that, we shall end this episode here and see you next time with another game. See you then.
That one which kills you.
I need a straight to get there up with you. Mm. I don't have that. Son of a bee-hotch.
No, guess you're down here now.
I'll find a way to escape and come back after you, evil black dragon son.